Now, all of these modifications can probably add 50 to 80, maybe up to 100, depending on if you're using E85 fueling or not. Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. Today we're talking about performance modifications and upgrades for GM's 6.0 Vortec engine. The 6.0 Vortec was used from the late 90s all the way up until 2019, and it was used in everything from 1500 to 3500 plus series trucks in their half tons and their HDs as the diesel equivalent. The 6.0 is a fantastic engine because it's extremely reliable. It doesn't come with any of the AFM or DFM fuel management crap that all the other GM engines have, and it was significantly underpowered relative to the amount of power that it can handle. So it was over-engineered to a point that makes it extremely reliable, but also to a point that means it can handle a ton of power from a performance modification standpoint. Now, of course, spanning over 20 plus years, there are a number of different variations and generations of these engines that have differences. However, the primary architecture is the same for all of these engines, and so the modifications on our list are going to be the same as well, just because today we're going to be talking about our basic bolt-on modifications. But before I go ahead and give you a few disclaimers there, let's go ahead and talk a little bit about the power capacity and the limitations of this engine from a performance standpoint. The stock block is wildly powerful. There are instances of the stock block pushing 1500 plus horsepower without any block modifications. So the stock block is going to give you no problems on this engine at all, regardless of how much power you're trying to produce. And then the internals are also extremely strong as well. The internals can handle 800 to 900 horsepower. Before you start thinking about upgrading them, ultimately, unless you're trying to do, you know, a four digit power build, the internals are going to be pretty strong and capable on this engine too. And then the only main limitation that you're going to hit trying to get up to those types of power levels is going to be with the fueling system. Right when you get around 550 horsepower or so is when you're going to need to do larger injectors and use a stronger fuel pump as well. So ultimately, we can make a lot of power out of these engines. The one caveat is that once you start getting past the 500 horsepower mark is when we're going to need to add a lot of additional supporting modifications, especially once we talk about adding forced induction to these as well. And so at those power levels, you're going to need to do things like head stuff, valve springs, an electric cooling fan conversion, radiator upgrade. And at that point, you're going to start looking at more serious modifications like porting out the heads, either upgrading the intake manifold or porting out the intake manifold, and doing lots of other more advanced modifications to really improve airflow within these engines. Ultimately, we've got our list of basic bolt-on modifications here, which is great. These engines do respond well to supercharging and forced induction. However, once you start to add that is when the list of supporting modifications starts to build up rather quickly. So we're looking at a pretty hefty build from a cost or expense standpoint to be able to go ahead and push serious power out of these engines. With that being said, today I'm just going to focus on the basic bolt-on modifications for anyone who's just looking to add a little bit of extra power to their engine, but who isn't looking to dump tons of money into doing a 500, 600, however much plus horsepower build. So modification number one for the 6.0 Vortec is going to be engine tuning. Tuning is going to offer the biggest power gains on these engines. It's also going to offer you a great bang for the buck from a price per horsepower standpoint. Depending on what variation of 6.0 Vortec you have and whether you tune it for 91 octane or 93, you can get about 25 to 40 horsepower out of tuning alone. And these trucks respond well to tuning, and so you can get some pretty good torque gains out of it as well. You're likely looking in the 40 to 50 torque range. And there are two variants of the 6.0 Vortec, the L77 and the L96, that are flex fuel capable. So if you have one of those variants, you can go ahead and tune your truck for E85 fueling. And just by using E85 fueling and having the proper tuning for it, you can get an additional 20 to 30 horsepower out of these engines. Now, after tuning, the second modification on my list is going to be exhaust upgrades. When I say exhaust upgrades, really, the best exhaust upgrade is going to be long tube headers. Long tube headers alone will add about 25 to 30 horsepower on these engines. Of course, from there, you can upgrade the cat-back portion of the exhaust system as well. You'll likely see another, you know, 5, maybe 8 horsepower out of that. So the predominant gains come from the headers. You can go long tube or short tube. Short tube is just going to have a smaller performance benefit compared to the long tubes. And then once we have tuning and exhaust upgrades, the third thing on our list is going to be airflow improvements. What I mostly mean by that is adding a cold air intake. Cold air intake isn't going to offer a ton from a performance standpoint. However, it is going to help improve your throttle response, and you'll even see some small fuel economy benefits out of it as well. But it's just helpful to bring a little bit more air into the engine to help free up airflow. And so with tuning and intake, I'll probably add another 5 to 8 horsepower as well. So an intake's definitely worth it if it's within the budget. And then the second airflow improvement to talk about is throttle body upgrades. You can go ahead and upgrade the throttle body to improve airflow as well. A common thing on some of the older 6.0s is swapping the throttle body and the intake manifold with them from the newer 6.0s, since the newer 6.0s have larger intake manifolds and throttle bodies. But on the newer models that already have a larger throttle body, just doing a throttle body by itself probably isn't going to add a whole lot of benefit. So this is something that's a bit more important for the older models. The only other airflow modifications to really talk about here is what starts getting us into the more advanced things, like porting out your intake manifold and porting the heads and things like that. And so from a basic bolt-on standpoint, you know, throwing intake on it. If you've got an older version, go ahead and look at intake manifold or throttle body upgrades. But from there, that's about all that makes sense from an airflow standpoint on these engines. Those are really our basic bolt-on modifications here. Tuning an exhaust system, preferably a full exhaust system with long tube headers back, but at a minimum, just some long tube headers. And then the third thing is going to be a cold air intake. Now, all of these modifications can probably add 50 to 80, maybe up to 100, depending on if you're using E85 fueling or not. But ultimately, that's going to be about the cap from basic bolt-ons without getting into crazier things that have a lot smaller power gains. So from here, if you want to add a more significant amount of horsepower, we're going to be looking at camshaft upgrades. Camshafts can add 25 to easily 100, 200 plus horsepower, depending on what type of camshaft you go for. I will say on a daily driver or a street truck, you probably don't want to go any more aggressive than a stage 1 or a stage 2 camshaft, but camshaft upgrades can add 25 to 100 horsepower. And so definitely something to look into after you've done those basic modifications if you're looking for additional power out of these engines, just since a good camshaft alone can rival all of the power gains that you got from those three modifications prior to it. But of course, there's a lot more that goes into selecting a camshaft. And so we're not going to go into any more depth in this video. And then after that, forced induction or supercharging is going to be your next best route for the 6.0 Vortec. There are tons of supercharger options out there that range from very small superchargers that are going to add 60 or 80 horsepower all the way up to superchargers that can take you into the 1,000 horsepower plus range. There's a lot of things that go into supercharging, but once you start talking about supercharging, unless you're going to run just a very basic small supercharger and get 60 or 80 horsepower gains out of it, that's when you're going to need to start looking into a lot more of these supporting modifications like porting the heads and doing fueling upgrades and things like that. So ultimately a lot of decisions that go into it, but also a lot of money that starts being required to go into it. And that's why I recommend do these first three modifications on this list, get yourself an extra 80 horsepower or so, and then see where you want to take things from there. Anyways, guys, that wraps it up on our video on performance modifications for the 6.0 Vortec. If you guys appreciate this video, please click the like button and subscribe to our channel and stay tuned for all the future videos that we do on the 6.0 Vortec, where we might even talk a little bit about how to start cracking into forced induction to get significant power levels out of these engines.